Hello, and welcome to our commentary track for Return of the Jedi. I'm Mike.
I'm Rich.
I'm Jay. And oh, we're doing Return of the Jedi?
Yeah.
I thought we were doing Revenge of the Sith.
Nope.
I've never seen this movie.
What?
This is going to be a horribly awkward commentary.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Just pretend.
Okay, I'll pretend I've seen it before.
There's some teddy bears, and you don't like the teddy bears.
Okay.
And go.
Got it. Are there digital rocks added to this one?
There's a digital rock band added in.
Oh, yeah.
With the cartoon monkey.
There's a digital Hayden Christensen added to the end. And
oh,
his
Lord.
Acting is similar to that of a rock.
Disney loves money, right?
Yes.
Are they releasing a proper release in Blu-ray of the actual theatrical cut?
There's speculation, but I don't know. I don't even think it's up to them.
What?
It's a rights issue with the original, at least with A New Hope, I know.
What?
Was that little red moon added in there?
What?
You know what? If I were George Lucas and I was going to sign over the rights to Star Wars, and I absolutely did not want that TIE fighter was added on the left, and same with that stupid thing on the right, and I absolutely did not want the original versions released, all I would do is say, I'm putting that in the contract, Disney.
Lucas is a smart businessman.
He's got the upper hand with when it came
George
to,
Lucas has the upper hand.
That is a new shot too.
The zooming in.
That is some kind of digital extension on the size of the door.
Can we make that door bigger? George, that doesn't make just make the door bigger.
Just make the door bigger.
Yeah, this is the size of the original set.
Yeah,
that's big enough. It looks great.
I like that spider robot creature.
The Rebel Alliance could have taken him by force in about 4 minutes.
You just have some X-Wings bomb the perimeter for a few minutes. Yeah, and then they have a loudspeaker. Yeah, we want Han Solo.
What are those people back there doing? This is stupid. Inserting Boba Fett everywhere. That little creature there sticking his tongue out and eating something feels like a special edition ad, but it's
But no,
not.
That was always there. I love that there's 100 people just right behind this tiny curtain.
Maybe Jabba was just having his own orgy back there.
Oh,
it's just bad timing.
Okay.
Oh.
We're just going to do impressions of all the aliens for the rest of this commentary.
Ah, the Rancor.
Love the Rancor.
Everyone little tiny Rancor. Puppet.
I've always liked this little moment with the Rancor trainer.
Oh, yeah.
Little moment of humanity. Just this completely throwaway character, but they give him this little moment.
Oh, God.
We need more Banthas. How many Banthas can we fit in here?
Band playing festive tune. Look, he's holding a drink. I love Jabba the Hutt. Oh my God, Luke's hair. I'm going to stop this Jedi Knight by wrapping a tiny cable around him. Have you heard of Jedi Knights?
That's the end of your precious Boba Fett. All you people that like Boba Fett for no reason. Now, didn't they change a line from Han Solo here?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Lando says, "Oh, wait, I thought you were blind!" And then originally Han Solo said, "Nah, it's all right, trust me." And then now he said,
"It's all right, I can see a lot better."
Of course, the Han Solo thing to say was, "It's fine, trust me, I can kind of see."
Yeah.
But we had to change that to something more logical and pointless. They steal Jabba's property and murder hundreds of people.
So they can save one drug smuggler.
Yep.
This is a life-size barge, and they really blew it up. Yeah. And some, archaeologist was digging around, and they found parts of it. They're like, oh, my God, we found some kind of weird civilization. Oh, it's just junk from Return of the Jedi.
Get new haircut, you must.
Do I have to force you to go to a barber? And he said, yeah, well, do I have to force you to trim your ear hair?
Oh, Yoda, fix your ear.
Your eyes are crossed.
So here we have Alec Guinness coming up, looking like he'd rather be anywhere else. He's like, I'll come do the scene if I can sit on a log.
Why not just have Yoda do the exposition?
Because Yoda is hard to understand, and he was dying.
Let's give it to someone who's already dead.
Oh, snap.
You ain't all that and a bag of potato chips.
Ben, come help me kill Darth Vader. You could sit on this log. Can you hold this lightsaber? How is he sitting on the log?
If anyone listening to this hasn't seen it, find on YouTube the interview clip with David Lynch talking about his lunch meeting with George Lucas.
Yeah, that's the funniest clip.
I had such a headache.
Have you ever seen that, Rich?
Yeah, it was great.
Oh, it's so good.
I wanted to throw up.
And he showed me this thing called a Wookiee.
This tunnel isn't just a straight line that goes up and down. There's a plenty of fucking things to crash into.
He walked out of the lights.
This is the famous scene where you see Carrie Fisher's coke finger.
Oh.
Is it the scene?
Yeah, I think it's the scene.
Yeah, she leans over. Yeah, yeah, it's coming up.
Rich, explain to our audience what a coke finger is.
Basically, she's got one finger now that's really long, so she can shovel cocaine directly into her nose.
You know, if this is a Blu-ray, maybe we could see little speckles of white powder up her nostrils.
This was my favorite action scene from the series as a kid.
It was very exciting at the time.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously very dated looking now, but yeah, this feels like something out of the 1950s now.
Luke,
I've been here doing nothing.
Oh, you're Han Solo, right?
General Solo in command of five guys and an ape.
And inside the Wicket costume is, of course, Warwick Davis, one of the most famous little people actors. He was like a kid when they made this, right?
He was very young, yeah.
Like 13, 14.
He must have been 18. Check for coke. We got plenty of close-ups.
Anytime we get a close-up.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God.
Are the eyes creeping you out?
They're distracting.
It kind of looks scary. Hit it in the shin with a stick. That's a great idea. Oh, my God. Oh, what wacky hijinks are happening here?
Burr, 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 burr.
Fuck with me and my god friend. Fucking kill you. And then Luke decides now he's too good for all this crap and leaves.
I'm in the forest with a bunch of teddy bears.
Fuck this kitty shit. And Han Solo's like, can you please take me with you?
They just won't kill me off. Why won't they kill me off?
I just want to die.
Look at his face in like every scene in this movie. It looks like he's doing it sarcastic almost.
Well, almost?
Yeah, get used to this location. Han Solo is going to spend the next 45 minutes in front of that door.
This should have been Wicket doing this.
Yeah, this is just some random Ewok,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it is.
Let's all go after that bear. It's just one bear. You better take five men. He's got a spear. He's probably going to crash because there's no way he could possibly know how to fly that thing. Everybody after him. Like he's spinning around because he doesn't know how to fly.
Vines. This is a precursor to Crystal Skull. This is weird to me is that he's in focus. The background behind him is out of focus. And then the stars are in focus. It looks weird.
An entire legion of my best troops have reached him.
That big, look at that big thing.
Yeah, that's a big actual prop.
Uh-huh. I swear to God, I just saw a guy in a stormtrooper costume without his helmet on.
You did. There was one in the previous shot, too.
Oh, he's right there.
I don't know why that is.
What? Was that a rebel who put on the armor of a biker scout?
I don't think so. There's no explanation for it.
Oh, my God. Here comes all the teddy bears. Here they go.
Here's that door.
Get used to that door.
Get used to the door.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, here we go. There's the Tarzan yell.
What?
Did you just hear an awkward Tarzan yell?
Oh, here's where the Empire acts smartly as well.
Let's open this hatch.
Whoop, whoop, whoop. Right. This is like Spaceballs or something. Like,
yeah.
It's so goofy.
Mel Brooks said it's going too far.
Yeah. Return of the Jedi was just too silly for me.
Oh, no.
So, Han, how are things in front of that door?
Why did that stormtrooper stop shooting? Just keep shooting.
Yeah, freeze. Why are they telling him to freeze? Shoot them.
There's murderous teddy bears running around all over the place. You have to shoot these people.
Ah, good thing I had those strings attached to me when I flipped backwards.
Whoop.
Rebels have been routed. They're fleeing into the woods. Are you sure? Because every other line of communication says that the teddy bears are slaughtering everyone. You're the only person that says everything's going okay. I'm not sure I should open this door.
Let's all run out, too.
Yeah.
All right, well, okay, well, everyone, we're all going to run out because we trust this one guy. Everyone else.
I like Han's little smug gesture there when it's like, there's nothing clever about what you just did. You're just fighting really, really dumb people.
Can Vader not really find him, or is he just pretending?
Oh, man. We keep cutting to Vader, and he's looking back and forth. He's conflicted. If only we had some dialogue to make me understand that he disagreed with what the Emperor was doing. Why isn't the movie explaining this to me?
If only he said no, no.
Yeah. Oh, wait, wait. Oh.
Oh.
He's saying...
No!
Oh.
You know, I never knew what happened
there. Ever since I was a kid, I was so confused. Right. I'm glad that they cleared that up.
Should the Emperor have looked over? What are you saying? No. I'm going to zap you now.
Oh, he holds his little hand. That's so cute. This stuff's so fucking awesome. I love this.
If, like, he succeeded in turning Luke to the dark side, they all would have blown up 20 minutes later.
They would have, yeah. Emir Akbar just died.
I also kind of love that nobody bothers to stop Luke.
Oh, yeah.
There's people running around.
Well, this is, yeah, everyone's in panic mode.
Yeah,
now.
I know.
It's fine.
What's that guy doing with Lord Vader? Who gives a fuck? There's no, they needed, maybe they shot something, but they needed a scene on the Rebel cruiser where they kind of catch up. I thought you were dead, Han. You know, I've been miserable and, well, I wasn't dead. I was frozen. I don't know. I missed you. some sort of character interaction.
Oh, hi, Hayden Christensen.
Who's that guy?
Who's that guy? Luke would have no clue.
I guess that's some guy that Obi-Wan and Yoda are friends with.
He looks so evil. I hate this stupid song. Well, everyone, thank you for listening to our commentary track on Return of the Jedi. Have a wonderful day. And may the Force be with you.